GearNetwork.com.
The following is a presentation of the Gear Radio Network.
Hey, what's up? It's Sky from Sumo Psycho, and you're listening to the All Bets Are Off podcast with Robby Vegas.
What's up, Rock Soldiers, and welcome back to the All Bets Are Off podcast. No interviews this week. We had a couple bangers in a row for you there, but we're changing things up a bit. So what we're doing today is first introducing my first of two guests, somebody you may know.
Okay, that wasn't as impressive. It's a bottle of soda this time. What's up, y'all? It's Chazz.
So, Chazz, today we're going to be doing a draft of the four original Kiss solo albums from 1978 when they were still a band. But they each released their own album.
Yep.
We're going to do like a fantasy football style draft, and we're going to make one album each for the three of us.
There's rules.
There is rules. Go ahead.
You have to draft at least one song or one artist from one song from every artist. That's
yes.
the word I'm looking
yeah.
for.
Stroke.
Sorry, June. Sorry, June. Sorry, Gene. Sorry, Gene. And June. Sorry, June.
We were trying to make it fair because, in all seriousness, nobody would pick a Gene song.
No. And, like, maybe some people would think nobody would take a Peter song, but we're kind of Peter fans over here.
Yeah, so absolutely.
I'm interested to see what goes first overall.
Yep.
What's the 101, you know? You know, I'm going to see if anyone drafts When You Wish Upon a Star, which is probably going to be no.
Well, do you want to tell the people our third guest?
Yes, our third guest we got joining us remotely shortly is, call him a Kiss Encyclopedia.
Okay.
The man is, like, all-knowing. He's, like, the floating head. He's, like, the Zordon of, like, Kiss. He is also a big wrestling fan, so I figured bringing him on the show is great. It's Joe Polo from Podcast Rock City.
Perfect.
One of the best Kiss podcasts out there.
Well, we're going to get him on the phone, but before we do, I'm sorry, we're not going to get him on the phone. We're going to get him on the Skype machine.
On the Skype thing.
But before we do, I have to talk about our first sponsor of the day, because we always have more than one, and we're heading back to our good friends over at Bruce. So do you remember this?
Yes, kind of. It sounds familiar.
All right. So today we're sponsored by Bruce, which is an electric toothbrush
yes.
that'll change the way that you think about brushing your teeth. With powerful sonic technology and ultra-gentle bristles, the Bruce redefines what it means to have super clean teeth. It's like that feeling when you just leave the dentist, a fresh whole mouth clean every single day. Our listeners get 15% off their total purchase with code POD15. Follow the link in the show notes and enter the code POD15 to get your exclusive discount and upgrade your oral care routine. Make sure you check those out, and we'll get to the other sponsors a little bit later on. So we're going to play you.
So this wasn't, that sponsor wasn't for the Ring of Honor champion?
It was not.
No.
It was not.
Oh, that's Roosh.
Roosh. Not, oh. Yeah. Speaking of Ring of Honor, real quick.
Oh.
Real quick.
You look salty.
No, I'm happy that they're doing a women's tournament
for
a women's title.
Yep.
And my girl Vita is
friend
of the show, and she's doing awesome things.
Yep.
And I've been seeing her more and more in all these different companies popping up. So shout out to you, Vita. I'm super proud of you and very happy for you.
Rock on. And then they got pay-per-view coming up.
Yeah.
So wrestling's back.
It is back.
That's
and
awesome.
I hear The Rock's going to be at SummerSlam.
You hear.
I don't know if that's true.
This is rumor.
It's rumors. Well, rumors start somewhere.
That's true.
Braun Strowman's going to AEW.
Oh my God. He will not go to AEW. That is the last thing that will happen. Oh, my God. He'd be eaten alive in AEW.
AEW fans are threatening to stop watching if Braun Strowman
gets
signed.
He would lose to Jungle Boy or something like that. Darby Allin would, like, have a win streak over him.
Well, listen. What song off one of the solo albums should we play right now before we get Joe here?
Should we do... Let's do Tossin' and Turnin' from Peter Criss.
All right, here we go. Tossin' and Turnin', Peter Criss.
So, Joe,
thank you so much for being on the show. Your first time, and I say first time because we're likely going to have you on again, because once you come on, you have to keep coming back. That's just the way it works.
Absolutely. Yeah, and I would love to come on and talk wrestling, too.
Absolutely. I mean, you're on a pro wrestler's podcast. So like,
yes, that's amazing. That's awesome. I've been in the ring once myself, and I got hurt. One time in the ring. Actually, I never made it into the ring. That's kind of
purple. Tell that story.
There was a wrestler that was, he was a guitar playing metal rock guitar playing wrestler guy. And my band played the local wrestling matches. We were called Bay City Psychos, and we wore hockey masks, and it was always over the top. Like, it was a Kiss-influenced kind of show, of course, with pro wrestling, and I love both. So I was like, so you're telling me I could get in free to the local wrestling and meet the pro wrestlers and play?
Yeah.
And I did. So, like, through that wrestling organization, I met, like, DDP and Devon Dudley. And anyway, so this guy, he comes into town, and he hears that there's a rock band. So he goes, I want to have a guitar battle with the lead guitar player. So I did the battle, and of course, I'm a bad guy, you know, because the bad guy wrestler loves us. So they bring me in the ring after the fans vote who wins, and I'm not going to lie. The guys voted for me. The girls voted for the guy. and not to be too weird, but he was good looking. Long blonde hair, muscles, tan. You know, when he played his guitar, he looked like Kane Roberts. You know who Kane Roberts
is? Oh, yeah.
Alice Cooper.
From Alice Cooper.
Yeah. Yeah.
But, so he beat me, and I went into the ring, and I shook his hand, and when he went to let go, I held him, and the other guys jumped him and kicked the crap out of him. Well, about a month later, he was coming back into town, and he got in touch with us and said, part two. So we were playing, he's in the ring, and me and the guys surrounded the ring after he in the middle of his match, and I jumped up on the apron. He ran over and hit me, and I fell. You know, I was supposed to do, what do they call it, a Luger bump or something like
yep,
that?
Yeah.
Or I smacked the ring, right? And the guy said to me, and this is the best part, hey, listen, when you drop down, don't hold the top rope. I said, okay. So I dropped down, and naturally, I held the top rope.
Right.
And I'm going to let everybody know, the reason why he said that was because the floor I can't reach.
Right.
From holding the ring. So my shoulder just got ripped out of the, like, oh, man, I'm still having problems. But the rest of the bandmates jumped in and was fighting them, and they DDT'd. And it's a great video. I'll send it to you guys so you guys can see it. It's one of those really funny things that somehow. So, I mean, for real, I got the crap beat out of me by a wrestler. It's awesome.
we'll share it.
Well, we'll share it. That's awesome. That's one of the reasons I wanted to bring you on, too. Like, yeah, we're going to focus on Kiss today, but, like, I know you're the big, like, I called you the Kiss Encyclopedia, but, like, I know you're a big wrestling fan. Me and you have had chats about it, but I feel you never really got to open up too much about it, so.
I am so happy that wrestling is on every day right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I mean, I can watch, well, Wednesday, but the basketball stuff going on right now, not so much. But, you know, on my show, I had Chris Jericho on, and the first time he was on, I fanboyed out so bad.
I was listening. Mark,
and I was just like, oh, this is so embarrassing. And then I love it. If it's in town, I'll go. I haven't gone in a year. The last time I went was ECW. It came to town. That's when Cody did the backflip off the cage.
Oh, yeah,
against,
yeah.
Yeah. I was there for that. I got it on video. It's nuts,
and
man.
He broke his toes.
Yeah. Meanwhile, the entire, now you got to remember, this is like March, okay? So it's March. Behind us, and my girlfriend Karen's with me, and I'm not paying any attention, but she was. And behind us, there was a guy coughing the entire time.
Oh,
well, I wound up getting really sick, and then she wound up getting really sick, and we're pretty sure that we got COVID from that dude, because was one of those really wicked experiences.
This guy would know.
Yeah, I had COVID and it sucked. I was approved. I was like approved.
You were approved for COVID. Approved for so COVID. You took it.
I said, why not? I'll be the martyr. No, it sucked. But it's funny because you said that. Me and Robby were at the last SmackDown.
Yeah.
The last SmackDown was in Buffalo. And then there was that Raw on Monday, and then the shutdown happened on Wednesday.
Good grief.
So, yeah. Like,
I was so sick from that I... No, I'm not joking, and you know me, man. I talk about myself. I don't care what anybody thinks. I was laying in bed, and I knew that if I got out of the bed, I was going to have such bad chills. Yeah. You know, it's so terrible. So I literally laid there and contemplating just peeing in the bed. I have a big bed, so I thought if I just roll over to this side and then roll back, I'll be just fine. And I didn't do it, of course, because I'm a germaphobe.
Yeah, so. Right.
There's a good chance you might have had it, because, I mean, that was bad stuff. But another wrestling question I want to ask you before we get rolling in Kiss is, how many WrestleManias have you been to?
Okay, so Atlanta, Miami, Orlando, New Orleans, that was Undertaker's loss.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
I think that's it. Wait, Miami, Orlando, Atlanta, yeah, four.
Ah, you got me beat. I went in March or April, whatever it was, down to Tampa.
God, I wanted to go so bad.
It was cool. It was a different experience, like being there in the stadiums, as you would know, like, you know, you're just packed in there, but this was still during, like, social distancing, so, like, you're in wrestling. I talked about this on the podcast. You're there, I'm there, and there's all cardboard people around me, and then, like, down the street a little bit are some other people, and it's like, you know, you're kind of pointing to each other. It was weird. I'm happy I did it, and I hope I never have to sit through that again like that. Like, I hope we can get back.
Yeah, that's, it's good. I mean, they're opening it all back up. Yeah. So...
Yeah, so that was my three. I went to Tampa, I went to Orlando, but the Ric Flair retirement Orlando, and I went to Detroit. So those were my three.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, so I
want to go again.
Yeah, well, we got Texas next year.
you're right.
Dallas, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Dallas.
And then Los
Angeles. I'm thinking about going.
Yeah, maybe.
I'll hop on a plane and go. I have friends everywhere. I'll just call them up and say, I need your floor.
You're a Kiss fan, man. You got friends everywhere. That's right. How that works.
That's how it works.
So on the topic of Kiss now, that was a nice segue, by the way. You did a good job.
Thank you.
So can you just, before we even get into the draft, tell us, you know, for my listeners, what your podcast is and what you talk about?
So Podcast Rock City, I've been doing it now for, God, almost 8 years now. It's all Kiss all the time. And it's basically, I started it with some friends. After about 3 or 4 episodes, they bailed on me. And I was like, well, I'm having fun doing this, so I think I'll just keep doing it. So I did like 20-minute episodes. So every week I would do a 20-minute episode all by myself. I would grab a record, and then I would talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
And then I would send, and people were sending me, you know, emails going, this is the perfect kind of podcast because it's short and you got, you know, I don't have time to listen. But after about a year, I was like, it's getting harder and harder to do this by myself. And there was another show called Strange Ways. And there was this guy, Jody Havnot. And he messaged me and he said, hey, I love your show. Can I come on? And I was like, absolutely. And he has not left. He has been on the show ever since. And we started doing it where he would come on once a month. Then after a couple months, I was like, man, why don't you just stay on? We added another guy. He wound up leaving. We added another guy. He wound up leaving. And now we have Sonny Pooney, who's on a bunch of different shows. But he was on he was on one show called Growing Up Rock, and he was with us pretty much at the same time. And Growing Up Rock does everything rock. And then Podcast Rock City is just Kiss.
Okay.
And we just about a year and a half ago added Joey Quesada from the band ZO2. You might also know him as Joey Licious from Wrestling with Joey Licious on Amazon. Have you guys watched that?
I know what it is. I haven't watched it, but I love ZO2.
Okay, I'm going to tell you right now. The episodes for that are only about 5 minutes long, 5 to 7 minutes long. He always has classic professional wrestlers with him,
mm-hmm.
and they go by like this, but they're super funny. He's got like Tito Santana, he's got Roddy Piper. The first episode has Mick Foley in almost all of his personas.
Mm-hmm.
Nikolai Volkoff, the Iron Sheik. That episode has both of them in it, and I recommend that highly.
Now, Joey's a guy that I'd like to interview for this show because I fucking love ZO2.
Rob is a ZO2 mark. He is.
Yeah. ZO2 is awesome. And, you know, he just shot a new episode finally. And I think he mentioned it, so I can mention it. It's going to have Jake the Snake Roberts in it.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, so we're all excited. And I've already told him I need my belt signed by Hulk Hogan. And I know that he's messaged him, so I told him, whenever that happens, wherever you go, I need to be there. Like, I'm the guy that, like, tapes the boom together. So you don't have to pay me. Just, I want my title belt has to get signed.
I think I discovered ZO2 opening for Kiss.
Yeah, we saw him on
Go 4.
Yeah, I think it was Rock the Nation with Poison.
Yeah, that they did that whole tour.
Yeah. Yep, I did see that.
Right now, I'm a Joey Quesada commercial. He's going to love it.
Well, and you adding him to the show was great because I jumped in back in the day with you guys back when you had Andrew as your third. So I've been with you guys a long time. And then I've been a guest a few times, but like you and Jody are this consistent. But now, like, so you're like the Vince McMahon figure of this. You're like that comic voice. And now all of a sudden you bring Joey in. He's like the heel, it feels like.
He is the heel.
He is the heel of the show, and he's like the... Man, he stirs that pot. You got a nice rivalry with him and Sonny. It's great.
We might get into some arguments today over this draft. So,
yeah. Well, you guys picked the wrong songs, and I don't get them, and then we're gonna have to go at it.
Yeah, we're gonna have to fight.
But also, you got us on the radio.
Yeah, that's true. They were doing podcast Rock City Live on my brother's radio channel. And
you were telling me.
So I've been with these guys for a while.
Yeah, you sent us a message because I mentioned on my show, man, I'd really love to be able to play music. I wish I had a radio show. Bing, he sent me a message. Goes, yeah, we got a spot for you.
Yeah,
and now, still to this day, it was amazing.
And here we are. We're all intertwined now. And now, as a wrestler and you being a huge wrestling fan, now I'm going to send you some of my matches and be like, Joe, tell me if I suck.
He does.
Oh, okay, I'll be honest.
he does. The answer is he does.
He does it. Anybody that can do that is just before we go down to the Kiss, who's your favorite wrestler like of all time?
Shawn Michaels.
His fan, his fans know. We get it. He likes Shawn Michaels.
Listen,
I go the other way. I'm a Triple H fan.
That's a good one.
That's different.
You don't hear a lot of that lately, and I think that's a damn shame because Triple H is excellent.
He's badass.
Yeah.
I need to meet him.
And I'm an Undertaker guy, and you got to see his streak end, so I don't know if you're lucky or unlucky.
It was accidental. I was in the bathroom.
Oh, my God.
He walked out, and it took 4 hours for him to get to the ring. Me and my buddies, we were in the very last row, as far away from the ring as you could possibly get. Undertaker started to come out. We looked at each other and goes, hey, you want to go to the bathroom? Yeah. Now, we had to walk all the way down. Go into the bathroom. It was like a trough. That's all it was, like a trough. We go into the bathroom. We come out. We're sitting there. The match finally starts. We all went to the bathroom and came back. We're sitting there talking. And then there was like 4 or 5 pin attempts. And we're just like, we know how this is going to end. Let's get to it. And then all of a sudden, the third hand came down. And we were all like, you seen the video of that black guy with the
look
on? We were exactly the same way.
Yeah.
All right,
that's
enough wrestling. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
well,
no.
Here's a good segue since we're talking favorites. Favorite member of KISS?
Paul Stanley is a god.
Yes, I'm with Joe on that.
I know you are. I know. You know mine.
Yours is Peter Criss.
I mean, he's up there for me. He really is up there for me.
It's your son's.
It's my son's favorite is Peter Criss, but mine's actually Bruce Kulick.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Well, Bruce is awesome. Peter's pretty good.
Yeah, as he laughs.
Here's my issue with Bruce Kulick, and this pertains to both of you. You've had him on the show twice,
yes,
and not brought me on. And then Joe's had him on the show once or twice, but I specifically remember like episode what I'll just make up 115. I was a guest. 116. Bruce was the guest. 117. I was the guest. I specifically I remember that. So thanks to both of you, I got to never talk to Bruce.
All right,
Kulick.
Moving on.
But that's not true. I got to talk to Bruce Kulick. I met Bruce when I met Joe at the Indie Kiss Expo in 2018. So
there you go.
Yeah. That was a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. So, Joe, Chazz is going to be, you know, keeping tally on what songs get used so that we don't overlap. So he's got the list in front of him. So as we use them, he's going to be checking them off because all three of our albums are going to be different.
Yep.
Hey, he's got the records right there.
So the rules are, just to remind you and remind the listeners, you have to take one song from each artist. It's a total of 8 rounds, so you can't just take all Ace and Paul's. He's got to be a Gene song on there. Once a song is picked, it's gone. It goes in like a snake format, so like the person that picks first, second, third, and then this next round will go third, second, first.
And
so
you'll keep track of that also.
So that second pick's always in the middle.
So how are we going to determine who's picking first?
You can go first. I'm fine with you going first.
This was your idea. So why don't you pick first just because this was your idea?
So I pick first. Yeah. This was my idea. Okay. So now this comes down, and I want to talk about, you know, we don't have to talk in depthly every song, but if something comes up, comes up.
Yeah.
So I just stated that I'm the ultimate Paul Stanley Mark as well as Joe over here. So now, do I start with a Paul Stanley song, right? Or do I start with a good Gene Simmons song since there's not many?
Because there's one.
And maybe I get the one good one, right? So, but would you be surprised that the easy 101 for me, the first overall pick, and I think it is probably the best song on all the Kiss albums, is Rip It Out from Ace Frehley.
Of a bitch.
That is.
I'm not even going to lie. I'm fine with that. So far, my number one is safe.
So that's I figured, I didn't think it would come back to me. And objectively speaking, yes, Ace. Well, there's always that argument, which album's better, Ace or Paul? They're both fantastic. Hold Me, Touch Me could maybe get rid of that. All right. But other than that, I think Rip It Out with the drum solo in the middle of it, It just makes it for me. So Rip It Out is on the list. I see Robby crossing off. So Robby's making.
Yeah, stretches. I don't have a list, so I may repeat things. I'm going to try not.
Well,
to,
if you really if, so we'll follow the rules that follow my fantasy football.
I have my notebook.
He's a Kiss guy. He just shows a Kiss notebook. So Joe, if you repeat a song that was already picked, you have to buy us shots. That's how.
Problem. What do you drink?
Cold gin, of course.
Oh.
No, that's disgusting.
I've never had it.
Yeah, that's so disgusting.
Who's picking second?
So who's picking second? Let's let the guest pick second.
All right, Joe, you're up.
You're second.
All right, I'm picking Tonight You Belong With Me.
Yeah, oh, wow.
To me. I said You Belong With Me because I was listening to some Taylor Swift earlier, and I'm kidding.
You can't go wrong with that song by any means.
No, you can't. That's a great song. And now that it's my pick, I'm going to let you guys know that I did exactly what we talked about, and I picked a Gene song.
Okay, the Gene's going first.
Oh, I thought you were going to pick That's the Kind of Sugar Papa Likes.
I didn't say it wasn't on the list. Yeah. We don't know. But I picked Radioactive because I'm like, man, if I have to pick a Gene song, I'm going to pick it early because I'm going to get fucked in the end, and I'm going to have to pick When You Wish Upon a Star. So I went the other way, and I got Gene out of the way.
That's a nice first round. Rip It Out, Tonight You Belong to Me, Radioactive. And by the way, I believe that's all album openers.
Oh, yes. All album openers.
Yeah, so the first round, all album.
There's Kiss fans right now that are having a blast with this, going, oh, what the fuck?
Yeah, like that they're streaming, like, why didn't you pick Mr. Make-Believe? Yeah, exactly. Joe's face said it all.
Yeah.
All right, so how the snake draft goes, Robby, you're up again.
So I go first.
You're up again now.
Or second, whatever.
So first pick of the second round.
So my original second pick was Rip It Out.
Mm-hmm.
But you stole that from me.
I did.
So I had a backup in mind the whole time because I knew one of you. I point at Joe because I could see him for all our listeners. I knew one of you was going to take that one. So I'm going with Snowblind from Ace. Mm-hmm.
Good choice.
I'm fine with that.
There's nothing wrong with that. That's
Joe's making me nervous because every time we pick a song, he's like, no problem.
Yeah, he's like the classic, I got this, you're fine. Is Snowblind about cocaine?
It's got to be, I'm not here to confirm or deny what Ace was into at the time. Yes.
It's got to be about cocaine.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. Can't see a thing and he don't want to sing, clearly.
Clearly.
So that's a good pick.
I think Peter helped him write. Okay, well, all right,
yeah, all right, all right. You're throwing shots here. We got a Kiss professional on.
I'm sorry.
I'm not gonna lie. Shots at Peter Criss are fair game with me because he's the only guy I can't get. I have a bumper from every member except for him and one member that I will never mention his name. And I went to Peter and I said, hey, can I have one? Like, I have two from Gene, one from Paul, one from Eric, one from Tommy, one from Bruce. Hey, Peter, can you give me a bumper? I don't do bumpers. All right.
That was a great impression.
That was good.
I mean, forever in my head, I hear it. Oh, I don't do bumpers.
Well, I will say for the end of the road tour, Tommy Thayer, I was playing on the side stage that day for Kiss, and he did give my son an end of the road pick, and I thought that was really cool.
Oh, that's really nice.
So
it's really amazing when good things happen.
Oh, he was such a nice guy.
And Tommy's very underrated, by the way.
He is.
Too, so he gets a lot of heat, and that's not fair to him. So, Joe, you're up for your second round.
Second song, of course, to me, is the baddest lick on any of the albums, and that is going to be Speeding Back to My Baby.
I was pointing at it on the list as soon as you said the baddest riff. I'm like, yep, that's exactly what it is. I couldn't agree more about the baddest riff on that. And I like the cover of that. Who does it? The Donnas? Does the Donnas cover that?
Yes, I think they do.
Yeah. See, this is going to be...
That lick is cool.
It's going to be a very Ace and Paul heavy draft.
Well, I will give you a spoiler alert. My third and fourth choices are gone.
Well, that's why you need to be ready. That's why you need to be ready. That's how fantasy football works, too.
Now I have to look at the list.
Now you have to look at the list. All right, so I'm up for the last pick of the second round. I am going to go with, before Joe takes it on me, I'm going to go with Wouldn't You Like to Know Me on the Paul Stanley one. Because
that's the first time that anybody said anything on the show that has pissed me off.
See? I said it before Joe steals it.
I'll tell you guys both this. It was on my list, too.
Yeah, it's a great song.
So, yeah.
And you know what?
It was my next pick.
Yep. And it's such a... It's a great song. And like,
it is.
And it's a Kiss song, in my opinion, too. Like, I could see the guys working on it. And I'm going to start the third round and probably piss Joe off, too, because I'm going right in and taking the next song on the list, Take Me Away, Together as One. The bombastic drums at the end of that, Carmen Appice's solo at the end, like, I love it. I love that song. That was on our list of the greatest, greatest ballads, because I consider that a ballad, kind of, a power ballad. So.
Let me just go ahead and cross out three songs here that I...
That's
really funny. On our show just yesterday, because we did a show about the solo albums, I do believe Joey said that Carmine is totally overrated for that part of the song.
You know,
so that'll piss you off right there.
I've heard that. Yeah, I've heard that before. And it's like, how is that overrated? Because like, you left, Peter went off in most of the albums going up to that. So why couldn't Carmine? It doesn't make sense. I've heard that.
I think that it was, I don't know, it wasn't as good as people think or whatever. I don't know.
Well, he's the heel, remember.
That's true.
He's got to catch the heat. So now we're coming back to Mr. Polo for round three here.
I'm going to go with See You Tonight.
Oh, the Solid. Gene song. The Gene song. Getting it early.
That's not a bad one.
I mean, that's also on, which album is that on, Joe?
Yeah, see, why would you do that to me right now?
Yeah,
I don't know. I can't think about it.
It's on Love Gun, right?
That's that album with the thing on it.
That's also a Kiss song. That's the thing. Right?
It is a Kiss song.
Yeah.
I'll tell you this. I showed you guys that I cheat, because I will tell you, the other guys on my show know way more and remember way more than I do.
No, I'm actually confused. See You Tonight is a Gene song. It's See You in Your Dreams. That's a Kiss song. That's what I'm confusing. See You Tonight. That's because that rendition that he does on Unplugged is way better, I feel, than the album. And it actually made me like the song more on Unplugged.
That's fair.
It's a great song.
Yeah. So that's my you snaked me out of my Gene song. So thank you for that.
So who's up now?
So you're up to end the third round.
I'm going to end this round with What's On Your Mind, Ace Frehley. I was afraid it was going to get taken. I had another one above it, but all the Ace songs seemed to be going, so I needed to grab one.
What's On Your Mind is, I think, my brother's favorite song. And when we all met Ace back when me and Joe were at that 2018 Kiss Expo, my brother got Ace to sign his vinyl, and he signed it, Ace Frehley, What's On Your Mind, specifically for my brother.
Not going to lie, that is pretty awesome.
Yeah, so shout out to my brother down there on that one. So through the first three rounds, we've got eight rounds here, so we're almost halfway there. We've got a total of two Gene songs gone, 0 Peter songs, surprisingly, 4 Ace songs, and 3 Paul songs. So,
okay,
not bad.
Ace is the heavy hitter at the moment.
By one, right?
By one.
Yeah, so it's going like I thought, basically.
Yeah.
How you feeling about your team so far here, Joe?
It's a record I would listen to every day so far.
That's right, I like it. All right, Robby, start out the fourth round, Robby.
All right, I'm bringing in Peter. I'm going with tossing and turning.
Tossing and turning. Wow, he's going on the old school there.
Yeah.
I think that's a good one.
Yeah. That song is just so fun and catchy to me. And honestly, the first solo album that I ever bought of the four was Peter. So I think his is always going to hold a special place for me. And I like Peter's solo album, and a lot of people don't. I do.
I love Peter's solo album. It was the first one I had. And, of course, my mom bought it because the kitty cat was safe.
Yeah.
Now, did you have it in, like, the 78th time? Did you get it then?
Oh, yeah. I'm 50 years old. I had it when it came out. I used to take a blank pieces of paper and put it on top of the thing and trace Peter's face and color it in and do all that stuff. It's nuts.
You didn't draw a bumper on it, though, did you?
Makes me so mad. Now you're bringing it back up. Thanks.
Well, it's your pick, so you could probably screw me over here. So
great. I'm going to go with New York Groove.
Okay.
All right.
Arguably the biggest hit out of all the solo albums, right?
Yes.
For the first time, I heard it the other day, the original version, and I didn't like it at all.
No,
I don't like it either.
Most of those covers, like even like God Gave Rock and Roll to You, the original, it's not good, I feel.
It's so slow.
Yeah.
You know, unfortunately, for me being me, I don't go with searching out all this stuff. Somehow it just plops in my lap, and that's what happened. Somebody posted the New York Groove, and I was like, I'm going to fall asleep during this song. It's so slow. And you're so used to Ace singing it, you know?
Yeah, but right.
He could have written this song.
Yes, I agree. Like, it does sound like an Ace song. And I even remember, like, I've seen it in commercials. I've seen Kiss perform it with Ace. And I used to, it was even the theme song to a tattoo show, New York Inc.
Yes, yeah.
So, like, you know, it's pretty big.
It's been a part of a lot of TV shows. Yeah. I just heard it, like, 2 days ago.
Where are you guys right now?
We're in Buffalo, New York.
Buffalo, that's what I thought. They just posted, like, apparently the whole New York is back thing, and that was the song they used in the commercials.
Right.
So,
yeah.
So that's and it's usually it's always Ace's
always Ace.
Version.
Yeah. Always Ace.
It's always Ace's.
Yeah. So, I just heard it on Blacklist like 3 days ago.
Really?
Yeah.
So shout out to Ace for having probably the biggest hit of it.
Yeah.
I would say, but maybe
he's
not
listening.
Maybe not. He might be. Maybe not the best song because it was like the 4, 5, 6, 7, 10th song picked, right? But still, like,
yeah,
it's the 10th pick of the draft.
Well, we're also Kiss nerds.
Yeah.
So to us, we're going to be like, well, the hit isn't the best one.
That's like,
true, too. No, yes.
Nobody's going to pick, like, Shout It Out Loud or anything like that.
Right,
so
right.
I get it. All right. So my last pick. So this is the halfway point of the draft. So my last pick of the fourth round, I'm going to get some Peter love, too. I'm going to go with I'm Gonna Love You.
There you go.
I'm Gonna Love You. I like the way that song, like, bounces, and I like some of the chord changes in it, and it just is like a shuffly song. Mm-hmm. You know, it just, like, makes you kind of want to, like, do the disco dance, kind of. It's got the bass to it, and I'm actually going to pair back-to-back first pick of the second round. I'm going to pick the next track, Peter, You Matter to Me.
Oh, man. You're snaking the good Peter tunes, man.
I'm taking those out. You Matter to Me, for some reason, always, like, sticks in my head. I just, like, always say, because you're mad, it's in, and that's why. I don't know. It's always just in my head. So
I do got to say, as far as Peter goes, when he left the band and released Out of Control, that album smokes his 1978 solo album. Out of Control
it's
by Peter Criss
rock.
Is amazing.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not even going to go there because that would take an hour for me to unpack.
Well, we got next time. We got next time.
Oh, we'll do it.
I'm sure.
Well, we're up for you.
I went to his very last show in New York, and he played a whole, tons of the songs off of the solo album. I can't remember if it was all of them, but and that was just hearing him play those solo album songs was amazing.
Well,
I'm sure.
When you say play, though, was he drumming or just singing?
Both.
Oh, was he? Okay.
He played drums on, I don't know. I don't know how long the set was. I can't remember. But I would say he played drums on, let's say they played 12 songs, maybe more. Maybe he played drums on like 6 or 5 or 6 of them.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
And then he did a drum solo at the end.
Really?
With a, like a big band drum solo. I can't think of the name of the song, but because I'm not a jazz nerd, but or a big band nerd for that matter. But not that there's anything wrong with that. Yes, there is.
We're going on to Joe for his fifth pick. Now you're on your second side of your album now.
Okay, I'm going with. Now I don't see it on my list, so hopefully I didn't miss it. But I'm going with Move On.
It's still there.
That was a good pull. We're getting down on crunch time for Ace and Paul here.
I mean, there's still a lot left, though.
There is.
I haven't even looked at my Gene list because Joe took the only song I like, so I don't know what I'm going to do here.
you got to do something.
I got three rounds here to do something.
All right. I got to take a look here for my pick because I'm torn because there's a Peter song that I want.
I just
want
to say he's looking at the list with Ace and Paul's. He's not even looking at the
I'm
Gene.
Not. Because I already know the Peter song that I want, but I'm like, if I don't grab a Paul song pretty soon, am I going to be screwed here? Am I going to like my album when it's over? But Peter's running out of some tunes here. Mm. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do I Can't Stop the Rain from Peter.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I like that song.
I love that song.
That was the first song he played on that show that I went to.
I love that. I've always loved that song.
That is a good song. Peter's album sometimes gets a lot of, like, flack for being, like, you know, old-timey, jazzy. Yeah. But there's a lot of good things. Like, there's a really bad song that I don't think anyone's going to take, but I'll keep that to myself.
We can discuss
just
those
in case.
When we're done with the draft.
There's one Peter song that if either you take, I'm going to, like, harp on you harshly for it.
You would take it over some of these Gene songs?
I don't know. It could be. It's pretty bottom of the barrel. But we're back on you. We're back on you. Start of the sixth round. So we got three songs left here.
Ooh, okay. Give me these Pauls.
What? Give you what?
These Pauls.
Oh, okay. I'm wearing basketball shorts.
I understand. All right, hang on. I'm going to go with Ain't Quite Right, okay. Paul Stanley.
All right.
Got to write it down real quick.
That's an underrated one. It's not like one of my favorites, but I think it's very underrated. It's got a really, you know, it's got good guitar work in that song.
Right.
So I've always remembered that. Ain't Quite Right.
Plus, I kind of feel like right now my list is, it's slacking on Paul because my Paul choices were both taken. I don't know who took them. I can't remember. But they were Tonight You Belong to Me and Wouldn't You Like to Know Me.
Those are the easy choices.
Yeah. That's why I wanted them. These are great.
You're not making your ultimate list. You have to play by the rules here.
All right.
All right, Joe. We're on you now.
I'm going to go with Goodbye.
Ooh.
All right.
Off Paul's album.
Joe, what's your take on that 2006 one, or whatever it was, One Live Kiss Paul Stanley DVD?
Oh, where he did Live to Win?
The Live to Win tour, yeah.
Oh, man. I actually love Live to Win. I think that it's a terrific album. When you listen to it lyrically, Paul seems to have been in a really dark place.
Yeah, he's very open on that album.
Yeah, he's singing a lot, I think, about a divorce or something. At least it sounds that way. The band, those guys were all part of the band when they were trying to find that TV show. They were trying to find a new singer for NXS, and they were the band that played. I don't remember the name of the show. And then
Rockstar.
But,
was it?
What was it called?
Rockstar NXS.
Okay. And so they were really tight, but I would have rather it have been like what Gene and Regine wound up using, the guys from the Big Rock Show and just huge Kiss fans.
Yeah.
You know, and I remember when I did a show where I didn't know who was going to be in the band, and we picked people who we wanted to be in the band. Mm-hmm. And when they wound up showing Gene got his band, I didn't know any of the people who they were. I apparently wound up that I did know who they were, but I didn't know them by name, unfortunately. But I've gotten to know the guys. They're very nice. They also do a band called The Talisman. Mm-hmm. They wound up being Ace's backup band, and they I'm not even sure I want to call them a backup band because they pushed Ace and Gene very hard. So I would have rather that. I would have rather, you know, like fan, like I don't know the guys that were in the band, but it just seems more fun when the guys on the stage, you know, grew up huge Kiss fans, and you know, and they
you would rather
love
have the
being on stage with Ace and Gene, you know.
You'd rather have the Kiss lifers than the than the studio ringers. This is what Paul basically.
And they were studio ringers.
Yeah. And I love that album, but what I love about that live album, sorry, this is Paul Diatribe. Over there, Robby. It's okay. what I love about that album is the song selection, the songs he pulled out, because you said Goodbye, and that's the last song, I believe, on that DVD. And he brought out the solo songs. He brought out Kiss songs like a million to one.
Yeah, right.
And Magic Touch, like songs you never hear. And I also feel like that tour killed Paul Stanley, because after that, that's where his voice started to go down, because he was pushing out some songs like that I can't even sing in my 30s. He didn't bounce
back from.
And I don't think he ever recovered. And I feel like it was good, and in the long run, it was bad. So that's my take on it.
On the first Kiss cruise, they performed their two shows, and then we had heard that he left. And I don't know if this is true or not, disclaimer, but this is what we had heard, because everybody on the boat, you know, it's just people find out what's going on.
Yeah.
We heard he went to have surgery, throat surgery. And we didn't think anything of it, but, you know, obviously we started noticing.
Yeah.
Quickly afterwards.
Yeah.
But I mean, I don't give a shit.
Yeah. I
love Paul Stanley.
I love him. I think he sounds better now than he did maybe like 10 years ago. He's learned how to sing with where he is now, but definitely he's not the same. But he's also like 142 years old. So, I mean, what do you expect? Like,
and he's so cool, man. Yeah. He's so cool.
He is.
That's
he really
what
is.
About Paul.
Ultimate front man.
So, speaking of Paul Stanley, see that? Another professional segue here.
We're going to talk Paul Stanley.
People, welcome to the Paul Stanley cast. All right. I'm going to take on this pick, I think, the most Kissy song on Paul Stanley's record, and that's going to be It's All Right. I think It's All Right could have easily been on it, like any of those second, you know, Kiss, that second Kiss albums, The Love Gun, The Destroyers, all that.
Can I ask you a question?
What?
When are you going to pick a fucking Gene song?
I've got two rounds to take trash. Joe snaked me. Yep. I don't need to do anything. So, well, I'm going to start off the seventh round here.
You're right.
All right, and with the seventh round pick here, I'm going to take Love in Chains by Paul Stanley.
That's what I was hoping you would go with the Gene song.
You pushed him. You were trying to trick him into going to Gene.
I was.
And it backfired on you.
That was some reverse psychology shit, and he saw right through it.
Love in Chains, I think, is probably the most underrated song on this album, including by me.
I wanted that.
Including by me, because just his voice and that, no! Nothing stop. I don't even know
that's
what he
pretty
says.
Good.
Yeah, he just kills it, though.
Song's got a beginning where you go, yeah, I know that one.
And I love that you guys are doing all your favorite Paul Stanley stuff. That's awesome.
So, Love and Chains, great guitar solo with smoking in that song. Love and Chains, that's the pick of the draft. That won me the draft right there.
Damn, that was my next one.
All right, Joe, you're up, and we're running out of Paul Stanley songs here. Well, actually, the only one left is Hold Me, Touch Me.
No. Oh, is it really?
And I don't think anyone's going to draft it.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
So that's on you.
Well, I'm not.
Yes.
I'm going with...
Spoiler alert, he's not.
I'm going with this guy right here.
He's showing the cat, man.
Peter.
He's showing the cat, man. He's showing his Peter. Joe, stop showing me your Peter.
Yep. Well, it only takes up a small part of the camera. So. I'm going to go with Hooked on Rock and Roll.
Yeah.
Son of a bitch.
Good choice.
That was my backup. My next two picks are gone.
One of my favorite memes from this whole past year, obviously living through the pandemic and the start of vaccination, is somebody showed a picture of Peter Criss with a blue mask on standing in a line, and it said, Peter Criss waiting for his vaccination, .. I wonder if they're going to use a Victrola needle. And
nice.
That just made my life. And that reminds me of that song so much. And I'm surprised it took that long to get drafted. So good on you, Joe. Good on you. So, Robby.
Oh, I'm struggling.
You got 7 and 8
I'm
here, bro.
I'm struggling right now.
Got 7 and 8 here.
Damn. I think it's safe to say it's coming down to Ace and Peter. Yeah, that's the one. I'm going wiped out from Ace.
That's a good one. You sure you don't want any of these Gene songs?
I'm positive. Positive that I picked my Gene song first.
You're right. All right, so you got your last pick of the draft here.
I'm going Peter, but I got to choose wisely here.
You better not pick the one. I'll make fun of you. This one's gone.
That one's gone, yeah. My God.
See this?
Well, I'm going to tell you which one it's not.
Okay.
It's not Kiss the Girl Goodbye.
That's the worst song in the world, Kiss the Girl Goodbye. I hate it.
Oh, man, we're going to fight.
Oh, man.
I'm bouncing back and forth between That's the Kind of Sugar Papa Likes, An Easy Thing. I already picked a slow Peter song. I'm going to go with That's the Kind of Sugar Papa Likes.
That's the right choice. Joe, what, you like Kiss the Girl Goodbye?
I do, man. It's, I I'm not sure why.
Yeah, I'm not sure why either.
Okay, but here's the thing. I remember being a little kid and taking that record and putting it down, dropping the needle, and there was some silence. And when it started, I don't know why, I just remember looking at my mom and my mom saying something like, 10 seconds into it going, oh, I like this. And I just, I don't know, it just puts a memory in my head. And every time I hear it, it's just, I go right there.
Well, you know, I got to say, I'm in between you both because you hate it and you like it. And I'm just kind of like,
well, it makes sense for him. He's got warm, nostalgic feelings. So, like, 1978, Joe was probably, what, like 40 years old at that point? But, like, you know, he's probably, like,
right in the balls.
8 years old or something at that point. Like, it's...
Depends on when... the records, I think they came out in October, if I'm not mistaken. And so I would have been right around 8. Yeah.
So, like, that, you know, it's a little kid. I mean, it's a soft song. It's chill.
I also remember thinking it was cool because on the back, when it said Kiss the Girl Goodbye, it was the Kiss logo. Mm-hmm. Like, Kiss the Girl Goodbye. And I always was like, that's so cool that they did that because they're still a band, but they're doing their own thing. And, like, you know, when you're a kid, you think of stupid shit like that.
Yeah, I mean, it's I don't know. I can't do it. It just sounds like a lame attempt at yacht rock to me. It's like Peter Chris trying to be Peter Christopher Cross.
Got it.
Nice. I like that. I don't give you any credit.
Well, it's your pick. Are you picking that one? What are you doing, Joe? It's your last pick.
This is my last one?
Yeah.
Shit. And I picked something from everybody, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
You've got bangers left, like Hold Me, Touch Me, and...
When You Wish Upon a Star is still out there.
Always Near You, Nowhere to Hide. You got some...
I'm going
to
go... I haven't. I'm going with Living in Sin.
Living in Sin at the Holiday Inn? I don't have much to say about this one.
two Gene songs? Is that what I is that what I just got?
Yeah, two Gene songs.
All right.
It's got Cher. Man, you know, she calls him up and
in
the song. She's like, oh my God, is this Gene Simmons?
you got to pick a Gene song. Have no choice.
Can I pick nothing on this album? Can I pick something from this 2004 Asshole?
Nope, we made these rules, man. That album ain't much better.
Asshole's better than I Am Going on Record.
Asshole is a work of art.
It is. Asshole is much like better than his 78 album.
Oh, it's better than the 78 album, but I still don't like it.
I like it. I love it, but I like it. That's what I'll
That's
say.
Fair.
That's what I'll say. All right, I guess the last song of the draft, just to be that guy, I'm going with When You Wish Upon a Star to close my album.
All right.
To close the draft. Jiminy Cricket, much love, When You Wish Upon a Star.
Well, I want everybody, now that we're done with our draft, to read through our albums 1 through 8, one at a time, and just let's just hear it flow to each other. So,
well, all right. I had the first pick of the draft.
So you go.
And I'll go first. My album starts off with Rip It Out, Wouldn't You Like to Know Me, Take Me Away, parentheses, Together as One, I'm Gonna Love You, You Matter to Me, It's All Right, Love in Chains, and When You Wish Upon a Star.
Now, just count go count through your tracks there and tell me who you got the most of.
So, most of it's Paul.
Yeah.
I've got 1, 2, 3 Paul songs. I've got 2 Peter songs and 1 Gene and 1 Ace, actually.
So, okay. So, you are Paul heavy, as expected.
I am Paul heavy. Or is that, do I have 4 Paul songs? I have 4 Paul songs.
I will tell you this, though. 4 Paul songs. That's a solid Kiss record.
Yes, it is.
That's a solid Kiss record.
Even with When You Wish Upon.
Yeah, because you would skip it.
That's the album closer. You can take the album off. It's game over. Right. It's good night.
Joe, read us through your list.
Okay, hold on. Let's see. This is, I'm trying to make sure.
I got it if you don't got it.
I got it here. Okay. Tonight You Belong With Me, Speeding Back to My Baby, See You Tonight, New York Groove, You Matter to Me, Goodbye, Hooked on Rock and Roll, and Living in Sin.
And you said You Matter to Me at 5, but that wasn't your pick. Your pick was Move On.
Move On? Oh.
Yeah, not You Matter to Me.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Yep. I see it right there. So, I did write that. Yep. Yeah.
So that's...
Move On. Yeah.
I was just offended because I drafted that. So it was just, I was thinking, sure, it's on my team.
Just remember, there's nothing in the Constitution that means that you can't be offended.
And are you also Paul heavy? Is that one, or are you more Ace heavy?
He's got 1, 2, 3, 4 Paul songs out of 8. Yep.
Okay.
And 1, 2 Ace songs, 1 Peter, and 2 Gene songs. Wow. You're the Gene heavy of the crew.
Yeah.
Well, I got to tell you guys, before I even read through mine, my original 8 that I picked, I got 1 of them.
Of course.
Nice.
Every time I was like, I'll get that one next round. One of you had
and
it.
And the
already.
One you got was Gene.
Was Gene.
Yeah.
Because nobody wanted to pick from Gene, so I just took it first. So anyways, my list is Radioactive, Snowblind, What's on Your Mind, Tossin' and Turnin', I Can't Stop the Rain, Ain't Quite Right, Wiped Out, and That's Kind of Sugar Papa Likes. And I am very Ace and Peter heavy. I only have one Paul song and one Gene song.
Yeah. You are definitely Ace heavy.
Yeah.
You're the one. I'm actually surprised because looking at what's left on the list, there's three Ace songs left.
Yeah.
There's only one Paul song left.
Yeah.
So I'm surprised, like, and there's Peter songs, there's four Peter songs left. And
well,
Gene's whole album, basically.
I got one Gene, I got one Paul, and I got one, two, three Ace, and one, two, three Peter.
Yeah. So, it's just so, surprised me that Aces didn't get picked clean.
You guys took my shit.
Well,
let me, actually, just for fun, let me read you guys what my list would have been had I gotten the songs I wanted. I still went Radioactive from Gene, because his album sucks. And then I had Rip It Out, Tonight You Belong to Me, Speeding Back to My Baby, Tossing and Turning, Wouldn't You Like to Know Me, What's on Your Mind, and then I Can't Stop the Rain would be my closer.
That's a good record.
That would have been a good record, but you motherfuckers.
Well, you brought Kiss nerds on. What do you expect?
I'm trying to think, what was on the sampler? The one that they sent out.
See, this is guy. You. This is you now. This is on you. I couldn't tell you.
Okay,
see, well, you're like, I put you in the upper level of, like, Kiss nerd, and we're, like, in the middle level of Kiss nerd. Well, you got
it. Do you have a second for me to grab it?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, give me a second. I'll
yeah, we'll just talk shit about you.
So Joe's walking away to go grab the sampler so he can tell us what came out. So we're going to talk a bunch of shit so that when he comes back and sits down, then we'll launch into something completely
different. Actually, why don't you just tell him how cool his room looks?
Yeah, guys, like, we're on Skype right now. I know you guys can't see this, but he, in his background, has a heavyweight championship. He's got a bunch of Kiss posters on the wall, and it looks like some action figures, too, there.
Yeah, Joe likes to collect, and he does a good job.
Yeah.
And he's coming back, so we should
stop talking about Joe because he just sat down.
Okay,
oh, hey, Joe.
It's okay. We'll be the first. Most people do it right in front of my face, so I can take it.
So
they put this out.
See, I've never even seen that before. Like I said, you're the upper level of Kiss nerd. What you got there? The best of the solo
albums. Oh. The best of the solo albums. So I'm going to tell you these, and you write them down, and then let's see what you guys agree or disagree with.
Okay.
Ready?
Yep.
So there's three songs from each member on it.
Okay.
Ace is New York Groove, Rip It Out, and Speeding Back to My Baby.
Yeah. Those are the right picks.
Then Peter is You Matter to Me, Tossing and Turning, and Hooked.
Okay, I can see those.
That
I
works,
can see those.
Okay. Gene is Radioactive.
Okay, that's it. That's all we need. Thanks, Joe. Come on.
Mr. Make-Believe.
Ugh.
Really?
Ugh.
Uh-huh. And See You in Your Dreams.
Okay, that's fair, even though it's a Kiss song.
Yeah, and then Paul Stanley is Tonight You Belong With Me, Move On, and Hold Me, Touch Me.
Oh,
really? Hold Me, Touch Me. Wow.
That's what the record looks like.
There you go. We're looking at it right there.
So tell me something. I know you're a vinyl nerd, and I'm kind of a vinyl. Okay, I'm a vinyl nerd, too. Is that like, because the Kiss is the regular
German.
S's. Is that German? Show Robby. Like, show it up to the camera again. If you look, Kiss, they weren't allowed to have
The lightning bolt. Yeah.
So, see, I was a little nerdy there, too. So.
I didn't even know that existed. So, that's really cool.
When I don't feel like listening to all of them and I want to get a little bit of each of them, I drop that on. That's a really good one. They released they sent a promo to to radio stations as well. I think it had two songs from each of the members on it. It was just a black cover and said Kiss and then had their names across it. And I actually just got it not this past weekend, but the weekend before I went to a record show. First one in like over a year, obviously.
Jealous.
It was hundreds of people in there. Yeah, I live in Atlanta, so we don't give a shit. And I've had my shots and my girlfriend, that sounds terrible. We've all got our rabies shots. So, you know, we went. And there were people wearing masks and some not. You know, we looked through records and I came across that. I'd always wanted it and I came across it and I was super happy about that. So I have a lot. To put in perspective, I grew up, obviously, I'm almost 50. I don't know how old you guys are. You're younger than I am, I think.
We're 21.
Yeah.
So I grew up in the very early MTV era, and I became fans of so much music, pop music, you know, Duran Duran and even like Culture Club and Van Halen, all these bands, Journey. I didn't really get to see, I would have never seen them had it not been for MTV. Right. I sat and waited for Kiss that never came on, and I saw Michael Jackson and Madonna and all these bands. But even though I love all that music, I still have 150 Kiss records,
yeah,
and maybe 30 records from bands,
yeah,
that are not Kiss.
Yeah.
Everything else, I just hit go on the radio to listen to.
See,
so it's kind of nuts. You know, I got like 8 copies, yeah, of Double Platinum and, yep, 10 copies of Alive 2. Why? I don't know. What happens if one skips? And I got to have another one, so I guess it to it, it doesn't skip. It says stupid, but, you know, it's one of those things where that's been my thing. That's my only thing.
Yeah.
Wrestling and Kiss.
See, I'm like you, but not as much when it comes to the album. So I have every Kiss vinyl, and I have mostly all of the original, not maybe not original, but all the older pressings, and then the 2014 pressings, I have all of them. But I know you start getting like, well, there's an orange variant, I need to buy the orange one. See, that's how Joe gets. I don't get that much into it.
Hey, so, you know what? Since you're both sitting here, and I love it, the Paul Stanley Soul Station, so awesome.
I like it.
So awesome.
I like it. I've listened to it once.
Do you have the vinyl? You've bought the vinyl, I assume?
Yeah, here's the cool thing. I went online and bought the vinyl, and when it came, I opened it up, and inside, he had signed a CD cover and slapped it in there.
Oh, that's cool.
So
that's cool.
He did like 5,000, maybe, I think.
That's cool.
And I wound up getting one. I was so excited about it, as stupid as that is.
Do you have the violet vinyl?
I just got the black vinyl.
I got a violet vinyl of that. So now Joe's going to be looking for it.
I also want to tell our listeners that before we started recording, that Joe was telling us he owns a piece of Paul Stanley's carpet.
Yes,
and
here, I'll show you.
And there it is. He's got it right there.
Okay, so apparently Paul Stanley has had his house ripped down or something, and then rebuilt or whatever. And this guy, Paul
Stanley,
was on this different guy, Paul. He does these auctions, Kiss auctions. And there's a couple of different auction pages. If you guys type in, I think it's called Kiss Live Auctions on Facebook, and there's also one, Kiss Chikara Auctions, I think it is.
Yeah.
Two different groups. You could go on there. Well, this guy, Paul, he lives in California. Dude is a comedian. He's so funny. He's like 6'7". He's funny. He went to Paul's house when they were selling everything, even the carpet. And he bought the carpet out of one of the rooms and cut it up into a bunch of small pieces, and then fans could get it. Now, I'm going to touch this thing. I don't know how to deal with this. I have to get it framed. And even though it might be the cleanest carpet on the planet, in my head, Paul Stanley has had sex on this carpet.
That's not in your head. That happened.
I mean, come on.
Or at least eat and run away. Anyway, I'm not a wuss or anything. Okay, this is from Paul Stanley's house.
Tell me that's leopard print.
You people at home can't see it,
no,
but it's leopard, yes, printed. Yeah, okay. But I will tell you that I don't know how many of these have been sold, but if you go on, if you go to that website, to the Kiss, Auctions Live or something like that, you can find Paul Weber. He's got them. And it's not expensive. I don't know. I'm not going to say how much I paid for it. When I say not expensive, and somebody else is driving in their car going, what a dumbass. I'll tell you off air.
Yes,
and
yes.
Then you guys,
so is that Paul's carpet, or was that from the Animalized album cover?
I know. That's what I'm saying. The guy loves leopard print. Even his shoes, that he did for Puma had like leopard and zebra and all this other stuff. What's that, man? You can't go wrong with the patterns that God made. I think that's what Paul said.
Well, listen, I want to wrap this up by saying this. Would you buy that album that you just made?
Yeah, absolutely.
Joe, would you buy yours?
Yes.
I would also buy mine, so I think we're all satisfied.
Yeah, I'm probably going to make a playlist of all three of ours.
And just run them through.
Yeah, that's super cool. It was a fun experience.
When it comes to them, though, I'm going to let you guys know that I know who has the best album.
Oh, my God. He's got another belt.
And Joey I'm going to go with I'm the champ. And I'm going to base mine. First of all, I wouldn't buy Chaz's because it has When You Wish Upon a Star on it. But ours, the other ones, yes, I'll get those.
All right. I'm still, then that makes me the Intercontinental Champion.
It's fine.
Yeah. Okay. That's fine. White belt? You want the white belt?
I definitely want the white one or the yellow one.
Okay.
I'll be 24/7 champ. It's all good.
The 24/7 championship is the highlight of the entire pandemic. I don't care what anybody says.
Those guys, agreed. They make it fun.
They did a great job. Joe, thank you for being on, man. I appreciate it. This was so much fun. So you're going to come on again?
Sure.
All right, we'll talk some whatever. We'll just talk Kiss for hours. I don't care.
It's like, I give Joe his time to talk wrestling, though. He talks Kiss a lot. We'll get you
that's
on
true.
Wrestling.
We should do a wrestling episode with you, and we'll make it a real fun one again, where we'll make some kind of list.
Yes. We'll do a draft.
Yeah.
We could do a draft.
We could do a wrestling draft.
Ooh.
An era, though.
But we got to pick specific eras.
Yeah. Like an Attitude Era draft.
Yeah,
know,
Golden Era draft. Yeah. Like, we'll have to break it up into Ruthless Aggression Era draft.
There you go.
I love it.
All right, Joe, thanks for being here, man. I appreciate it. And for all of our listeners, before we go and I let these guys say goodbye to you, remember to check out deathcomeslifting.com. Become a member of the Lifting Dead Army. This is fitness for the misfits. And being a professional wrestler, I love these guys. And if you're into rock and metal and horror and punk rock, this is your site for getting in shape and still staying true to yourself. So I'll let you guys say the outros that you want to say.
Well, I'll go before Joe because I want Joe to end it the way he ends his show. Give him a little flavor. So I'll go, thanks for coming on, Joe. It's good to talk to you again. I haven't been on your show in a while, but it's good. I'm happy to bring you on ours, and I'm going to bring you on again. I'm sure of it, and we had fun, and I want you to end the show the way you end your Podcast Rock City and let everyone know what's up.
Okay. Well, Podcast Rock City, we do the show live every Sunday at 5 p.m. Eastern Time. So if you go to Facebook or YouTube, you just type in Podcast Rock City, follow us or subscribe or whatever. I'm old, so I don't know what any of that crap is. Click a button and ring a bell. That's all I know. Go to it and watch it live. Other than that, it's on, all the places you
it's
get
it's everywhere.
Your,
anywhere you
your
can
podcast.
Get Robby's podcast, yeah. You can get Joe's.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know what I'm going to say? We love podcasts, and we love rock and roll podcasts, and wrestling podcasts, and Kiss podcasts. And you're going to hear the commercials for all the ones that we love right after this in 3, 2, 1, peace!
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference. Who you are, anything your heart desires will come to you.
The preceding presentation has been brought to you by the Gear Network.